Bonsoir à tous et merci d'être là pour une nouvelle leçon. Aujourd'hui, nous allons parler des informations pratiques sur soi. So I would like to help you to give some personal information about yourself. We've done that a little bit before, but I realized that just giving a random class actually, I realized that some of the very basic things you should know, I think, at a basic level, sometimes you don't, because it's not that obvious. So, for example, giving your complete address, like, be able to give votre adresse complète, following the French format, because there is a way of giving your address in French, actually. There is also a way of giving your phone number, especially if it's a French phone number. Let's put ourselves in situation. Your email address. Or if you're on the phone, give your name and spell it quickly enough, like to not be thinking too much about. And also, if you have an accent, a stress in one of your name, like how to give this accent that we put sometimes on the E or that one. So I would like to let you know about that. And date of birth. And then your status. I mean by that, if you're married, single, divorced, separated, stuff like that. So, to start with the address, for example, in French, you would give first the number. If you live, for example, I give you an example of a French address and the literal translation. So, if I say, I live, j'habite 15 rue des Cerisiers. J'habite 15 rue des Cerisiers. That's how you would say it. First, the number, 15, rue, street, and then the name of the street. Des Cerisiers, why not? Cerisier, it's the tree that makes a cherry. It's a very typical name, Cerisier. I'm sure you would. Otherwise, we give like names from famous people. So, rue de Marcel Proust, for example, something like that. But first, the important is to know that we put like the number, a comma, if you write it. Then the type of street. It's not always rue. It could be avenue, boulevard. Boulevard is huge, but it could be avenue, rue, impasse sometimes. Much less common, of course. Impasse is when you can enter the... I can't remember how we say in English, but I'm sure you will get me. It's when you can enter the street one way, but then you have a wall and you cannot... go back. So that's une impasse. Donc rue, avenue, boulevard, impasse, allée, une allée. It's a kind of it's much smaller than a street. So you would say une allée. That's it. I think that's more or less that. So the number 1, 2, 15, 220 doesn't really matter. The type of street you live in: rue, avenue, boulevard, impasse, allée. I think with that we have almost everything. The name of the street, if it has to have a name. And then you give your zip code, which is normally like two numbers and then three more. So you would say first, if you live in the center of Paris, for example, you would be 75. That's for sure. If you live in the center, 75. And then you say 75,000. And then if you live in the first, you know that Paris is made of different arrondissements, which is like some kind of circle that goes bigger and bigger. So if you live in the first arrondissement, you live in the very center of Paris. So 75,001 Paris would be a possible address, for example. And it works this way, usually. You have like the what we call the département, that's where you live, and then different kind of numbers. This can vary, but you just need to know how to say it. So I gave you the example of 75 rue des Cerisiers, 75,001 Paris. That's your address. That's the full address. Then your phone number. So phone numbers in France, they are made of prefix, which also depends on which région you live, in which part of France you live. So for example, when you live in Paris and surroundings, all the phone numbers will start with 01. And then you have four groups of two numbers. Okay, so an example, You could, ah no, I was about to say you could try to write it down, but it would be like a maybe too difficult number. We'll try to make it easy. So if I live in the center of Paris, my phone number could be, mon numéro de téléphone est 01, and then I will make it up, 25, 15, 18, 30, That's it. So basically, 01, 25, 15, 18, 30. And you go 2 in 2. So what I said is 01, 25, 15, 18, 30. D'accord? Donc, pour donner des informations pratiques sur vous, mon adresse, j'habite, or je vis, and then 15 rue des Cerisiers, 75 001 à Paris. Mon numéro de téléphone est 01... 25, 15, 18, 30. Then I thought about the email address. This is not an easy one, for example. So it could be anything. If I put like, okay, mon adresse email est alicia.francais@, that's how you say, and there is no other way to say it, @gmail.com. Comme mon adresse email est alicia.francais@gmail.com. For example. Ensuite, si vous devez... Ah oui, alors, what I was saying before. Si vous devez épeler votre nom, it's to spell your, votre nom or something in your address, for example, that the person doesn't know how to write and she would be like, oh, vous pouvez m'épeler Cerisier, for example, and I would have to say oui, bien sûr, C-E-R-I-S-I-E-R-S, Cerisier. That could happen with your name. Imagine that your name is Emily. You would have to say E, accent aigu. Accent aigu, it's the closed one. It's when you have an accent on the, a stress on the first E, that is closed. I think if I do it like that, I'm doing it the opposite way. But you know what I mean, the closed one. So, Emily, the sound E, closed, that's called accent aigu. E-M-I-L-I-E, for example. That's for Emily. But if I'm called, let me check, because I want to give you the other E. I don't know. Hélène, for example. Hélène is interesting because she has both. Hélène would be, vous pouvez m'épeler votre prénom? Yes. H. E, accent aigu, E, c'est the closed one, Hélène, L, E, accent grave. Accent grave is the accent you put when you want to have the open sound, E. Yeah, because as you remember, E, the E letter in the French alphabet is completely neutral. It's the difficult one because it's from like the inside a little bit. It's very neutral, it's the E. So then if you want to make the sound E or E, you need to add either l'accent aigu, which makes the sound E, or l'accent grave, making the sound E, the open E. So Hélène, H, E accent aigu, L, E accent grave, N, E. It's important to know how to say that. And for the email address, I remember like sometimes some people have like underscore. That's fine, because now it's completely accepted to say underscore with a fantastic French accent. People will get it. If you say underscore, it's be like, oh, okay, that's the... But what we call it, and if you have someone who is a little bit less maybe modern and who doesn't know at all the English word, you would have to say tiret. Tiret is this underscore thing. And because you have the underscore and then the other one, the smaller one, then we say tiret du bas, bas means down, that's the underscore, or tiret du haut, which is the small one. Tiret du haut, tiret du bas. Underscore is more and more accepted, but I think it's good to know if you have to give an email address how to say these special characters that sometimes you have no idea. So, arrobas is important, point is important, and then tiret. Tiret du bas, tiret du haut. Remember also what we've just said with les accents. E, accent aigu, E, accent grave. Aigu makes a closed sound, E, and accent grave makes an open sound, E. Donc, j'habite au... Mon numéro de téléphone est 01 and then 2 numbers. And then l'adresse email with arrobas. Spell your name, careful with the special characters. La date de naissance. La date de naissance. Well, it's the same. So if you give everything in numbers, you would have to say, in my case, for example, 25-07, corresponding, matching like juillet. I can say, or 25 juillet 1984, or 25-07-84. More difficult though, on this I cannot really demand you to know how to say the year, because we haven't seen the weird things we do when we reach the numbers like 70 in French. So I'll be able to teach you until 60 very easily and you will memorize and that will be fine. But then we do something a bit special from 70 on. 70, 80, 90, we have some kind of weird calculation. So maybe to ask you to tell your birth year is not that easy. I don't know if you could hear, but I said 1984. Let's see if you can decipher that. That's weird. And after la date de naissance, the last thing would be l'état civil, le statut. Donc, vous pouvez dire « je suis célibataire ». Célibataire means single. « Je suis célibataire ».« Je suis en couple ». In couple. « Je suis en couple ». « Je suis marié ». I'm married. « Je suis séparé ». « Je suis divorcé ». « J'ai des enfants ». I have children. Even though that's not really un statut. But the main one would be « je suis célibataire, je suis en couple, je suis mariée, je suis séparée, je suis divorcée, légalement divorcée. That would be to talk about your état civil, as we say. And I think that's about it. So remember the format when you give l'adresse complète. It works really in that way. Numbers, type of street, the name of the street, and then the zip code with the city. And then the phone number, I explained to you how it works as well. You should really give it like 2x2 with the special prefix if it's a French number. Spell your name without forgetting the special characters et les accents. Remember when you give your email address, le point, arrobas, tiret du haut, tiret du bas, and things like that. La date de naissance, we'll talk again about it because it's not that easy. Et l'état civil that we've just talked about. I think that's about it. If you can really like control these different vocab things, you'd be fine when it comes to giving des informations pratiques about yourself. So thank you very much for your attention again. Merci beaucoup. Any questions, please let me know. And I see you very soon. Au revoir.